Oh, it's the longest.
Okay, it begins now.
Fuck. Sorry for taking so long, but you know, school, capitalized. Anyway, hope you enjoyed this final long chapter. And remember, no comments on his writing and other stuff like that. Chapter 6, Freddy and Jason versus the Hell Knights. Freddy was sitting down, sharpening his glove blades. Once the blade looked sharp enough, Fred stopped and sharpened them. He got up and grabbed another cigar. He grabbed a match and lit the cigar. He breathed in the smoke made by the cigar. Well, today's the day I'm allowed out of hell and allowed back in the real world, Freddy said. He then put out a cigar and waited. Just the fire appeared around him and fully surrounded him. He vanished from the place. Once the fire cleared, he was in the arena. It looked the same as before. Fire appeared next to the jets. Fred and Jason appeared. He was holding his machete, looking ready for battle. Okay, let's hope we win, because I'm sure we don't want to be stuck in this hellhole forever, Freddy said. Jason looked at Fred and nodded. Just then, Malcolm Petrucco appeared at front of them. Okay, now you two, it's time to see if you could complete the challenge, Petrucco said. Okay, let's go, Freddy replied, doing a smile. Very well, Malcolm replied. His hands glowed red and he did a chant. The ground erupted, opened, and two creatures crawled out. The creatures were taller than Jason and Freddy. Their skin was grayish green. Part of its mouth, upper chest, hands, and feet were red. The creature had no eyes, ear, or nose, and the creature was very muscular. They looked at Freddy and Jason and the snarling growl at them. Freddy turned to Brick Kruger. Okay, what the hell are they? Freddy asked. They are two of my Hell Knights. Also, can you use one of your special powers, Kruger, and Voorhees can choose up to two weapons. I see yet again he has one machete. Brick Kruger replied, doing an evil smile. He then vanished. This is going to be a problem, Freddy said, turning his attention back to the Hell Knights, who looked like they were ready for combat. Come get some, you big bastard! Freddy yelled at one of the Hell Knights. The Hell Knights did an angry roar at Freddy and charged at him. Jason went behind one of the Hell Knights and sent his machete into the demon's back. Red blood oozed out. The HK turned around and grabbed Jason and slammed him harder to the ground. The Hell Knights then started crossing Jason with his foot. Jason picked up his machete and stabbed the Hell Knight in the foot. Some blood poured out the wound, but the HK didn't move. Instead, it took its foot off Jason and picked him up again, then threw him away into a wall. Large tent was where Jason hit the wall. The masked killer got up and looked at the Hell Knight, now knowing that the hellish foe is harder than he thought. Fucking hell. Meanwhile, Freddy was having his own problem. The Hell Knight charged him and had him against the wall. The HK tried to punch him, but Freddy moved out of the wall. The fist of the HK got stuck in the wall. Freddy stabbed the Hell Knight in the stomach, pushed it out. Freddy pulled the four blades out. Then he started kick the hellish beast where he just stabbed it. The HK did a roar of anger and broke his hand out of the wall and grabbed Freddy and slammed him into the wall, then threw him away. Freddy got up and looked at the Hell Knight. He pointed at the creature and gave it the finger. Yeah, take that, you big moron, Freddy yelled. The Hell Knight just stood there, did a growl, and one of its hands glowed blue. Freddy just stood there, wondering what's happening. The Hell Knight sent a blue energy ball at Freddy, who didn't move since he was shocked. The ball hit Freddy in the side, sending him to the ground. It burnt his sweater and made a worse burn mark. The Dream Demon got up and looked at the Hell Knight that played at the HK. So you are more stronger than I thought, but the battle isn't done yet, Freddy shouted. The Hell Knight charged at Freddy. This is going to hurt, Freddy said to himself, and as he got ready for the charging Hell Knight. Back to Jason! The mask killed had been going well against the Hell Knight. The giant hell beast was slower now, since it had machete wounds. Jason punched the Hell Knight in the face, making it stumble backwards a little. Jason attacked the HK in the gut, making it fall down. Now Jason was able to pick up his machete. He picked up his fateful weapon and moved towards the HK, but one of its hands glowed red. It released its blue energy ball. The blast frenzy hit Jason in the chest, knocking him down. Jason looked at his wound. He could see his burned flesh. It was painful, but Jason got up, only to meet another energy ball. This time it hit Jason's shoulder. He dropped the machete and held his wound. The Hell Knight charged. Jason waited for the beast to be close enough, but he sent a strong punch right in the HK's face. The creature roared with anger and picked up Jason, then throwed him. But the Hell Knight was careless. He sent Jason in the path of the other Hell Knight, who was locked in combat with Freddy. Jason missed, mashed straight into the Hell Knight's face at full force, sending it to the ground. Jason was injured, but the Hell Knight he slammed into offered some protection. Freddy helped Jason stand up. The Hell Knight got up and walked right past Jason and Freddy. It walked right up to the other Hell Knight and punched it in the face. Both of them started roaring in anger and punching each other. Okay, Jason, let's finish this challenge, Freddy said. The Dream Demon walked towards one of the Hell Knights. They stopped fighting and looked at Freddy. Freddy pointed at one of them, the one he was fighting. You and me have an unsettled score to settle, Freddy's head. I walked towards Freddy, was about to bite Freddy, but he moved out of the way and stabbed the creature in the face with his four glove blades. The Hell Knight stabbed Freddy and flying into the wall, the HK walking towards Freddy. The other Hell Knight was fighting the battle. Jason felt a sharp pain in its back. Jason pulled out his machete and walked backwards. Just then a rusted metal box appeared and Jason opened it. He grabbed another machete. The box like it did before vanished. Jason looked at the Hell Knight. It was about to attack, but Jason, the mask wearing killed, got mad and started slashing and stabbing the Hell Knight like hell. Red blood went flying around Jason. He then stabbed the Hell Knight in the neck and started twisting the blade. Blood squirted out of the wounds. The Hell Knight did a weak roar of pain as it was trying to get the machetes out. The other Hell Knight heard his brother cries of pain and decided to help out. Just then Freddy slashes him across the back and went the front of the Hell Knight. Freddy then began to have a blue sort of mist energy around him and his glove shined blue. Freddy smiled and charged at the Hell Knight. The four glowing blades stabbed into the hellish creature's stomach. It couldn't move. It could still move its head. It looked at Fred's face, who was smiling. It looked at the Hell Knight's face. Now it's time! Meet my Soul Destroyer! He then pushed the blades deeper. The blue energy around Freddy quickly went into the glove and the blue energy went into the Hell Knight. Fred pulled the blades out. The Hell Knight's flesh began to dissolve. Its muscles and organs were seen. Blood went on the ground. The HK roared in pain as its organ began to dissolve and its muscles as well. All that was left after the glowing blue energy was done was some dust. Freddy stood victorious. Jason wanted the Hell Knight to feel pain. He decided to end it. Using all his strength, he was chopped off from the body. The body and Ted vanished into nothing. Freddy walked next to Jason. Malcolm and Drucker appeared out of nowhere and were smiling. Well done. Now it's time for me to send you back to your homes, Drucker said. He began to chant. Fire appeared around Freddy and Jason. Freddy smiled at Jason. You never know when we would meet each other again. But anyway, goodbye. Freddy said as he vanished into the fire. Jason vanished as well. Drucker signed and walked away. Now going back to finish his mission. Freddy looked around his dream world. He was happy, knowing he was stronger than before. Jason was looking around Camp Crystal Lake. It was fixed. He decided to go to sleep, knowing the job was done for now. Things might seem good for Freddy and for Jason and Freddy, but Malcolm Drucker failed. A marine from a place he worked before had defeated Hell's Mightiest Warrior and stopping the Hell invasion at the USC after killing the beast. But Drucker wasn't dead. He fused with a monster. It looked like a dragon with a large set of wings, two legs, and a clawed feet.
A long tail
and a head like a demon's skull, with no eyes in the eyes. Malcolm Drucker said it was on the end of the beast's tongue. The creature was called the Maledict. Hope you enjoyed this chapter. Anyway, the Maledict is from Doom 3, Resurrection of Evil. Also, HK stands for Hell Knight. Godzilla. Well, this story has ended. See you in the guys next time. Thank you, Gojira Mafu, for this song. Story. Fuck.
Oh, shit.
Wow.